Hello and welcome to my Android project. In this video I want to give an overview of the project. The project really took shape at the beginning of August 2019, because by that time I had finished printing the body of the Android. With the printing of the life-size model, I mainly wanted to know how the model would look in real life. Initially satisfied with the dimensions, the real work on the skeleton to move it began. First joints were the toes and a ball joint in the foot. Shortly after the first print of the foot, I noticed that the foot was much too wide for its length, so I narrowed the foot. In addition, at that time, about mid-October, I had the plan to control each toe with a motor in the foot area. The idea of running each toe individually with a single motor was, of course, completely nonsense in retrospect. The use of a normal threaded rod in connection with a two-week motor was also nonsense. However, I did not discard the motor in the foot area until much later. I have also made several attempts to make a skin for the Android with TPU. But I could not find TPU that was stretchy enough for the joint areas. In mid-November I had finished the first prototype of the ankle joint and found out that the ankle joint could also be turned, which was not intended. Afterwards I redesigned the ankle to a universal joint. Around the same time I started experimenting with silicone as a material for the skin. My first approach was to replace the skin with silicone only in the direct joint area. It was not until February 2020 that I came to the realization that I had to make the entire foot out of silicone to take advantage of the silicone's elasticity. Since then, I have also made several attempts to design a method for connecting the skin parts, but mainly because of lack of space I have not yet found a real solution. Until April I was also looking for methods to tension the braided lines so that the joints are without play. In the end I used a simple tensioner that can be used in the available space, which I released in version 0.2. In June I tried again to put a small N20 motor in the foot, which partly worked but made me realize that I should put a bigger motor for the foot in the thigh. Around July I had installed the end stops for the joints, but during the test I found that the self-printed pulleys had too much friction, so I replaced them with mounted pulleys. I also changed from M5 to M3 to fix the pulleys. At that time I also had the idea to give the foot more grip on the floor, because the silicone slides relatively easily on the floor and would probably break more quickly under regular load. That's why I put the TPU in the ball of the foot. But the same will be necessary in the toe area as well, which is why I've been thinking about possible solutions for quite some time now, because as I said before, the TPU is not stretchy enough for joints. Until November 2020 I worked on the knee joint and started with the hip joint at the same time. Although I am relatively satisfied with the second version of the knee joint, I had an alternative idea how to do it, which might even make the joint more stable. But that is pure speculation at this point. With this idea I question my decision to use a cord, at least in the foot and hip joint. For the toes I will have to use a cord because the motor will be in the thigh. But that's it for this video. If you want to know more, please ask me your questions, and if you're interested, make sure to like, share and subscribe.